peace and stability. What are the main reason behind inviting President Sisi to the United Kingdom to visit Britain, in spite of the blackmailing happened and the campaigns and the effort to cancel this visit?
Well, I'm not a member of Her Majesty's government, but I think it is important that even when you don't always agree on everything, it's important to talk, it's important to have a relationship. I said that between them, Egypt and Saudi Arabia are undoubtedly the most influential countries in the region. Egypt has such a long history, of a civilization, of its relationship with the United Kingdom. It is very natural that our government would want to talk to your president. And it, you know, often in politics you have flying visits in and out of countries. I've done it when I was a government minister. What is really good is when you can have 2 days when you do a lot of talking, when you have a conversation, then you can go back to what you talked about a few hours later and you can talk about a whole range of different issues. And I think that being able to have that conversation over the few days at the end of this week will be very important, because two leaders will get to know each other.
You think it's a little bit late?
I don't think it's a little bit late, no. I think it is...
It's in time?
I hope it's in time. There's never an entirely right time. You just refer to the fact, and you use the word blackmail. It's not a word I would have used myself. I think a lot of people are genuinely concerned. And as I said earlier, we're a democracy. We listen to concerns of people who are worried about some of the aspects of domestic law in Egypt. But having said that, it is important that this conversation happens, and it happens with goodwill, that it happens constructively, and it happens with real